Hello again, it's Rüdiger Heinrich with HV Mining. In this tutorial number 6, I would like to show you how to use the visualization features of Neoflow. So during the last couple of tutorials, we have basically completed drawing our plant. So now it would be the time to start it for the first time. So we run the calculation mode. And what you will notice is that all the screen openings are now showing the correct values. But other than this, we are not seeing much of our process flow, and for this we want to use visualization. So first let's let's put the object naming a little bit out of the way. And make it appear in a different design. So I am going to open the label options for our stockpile label. So this will be a machinery name. I would like to display this in a pale blue color and put a rectangular frame around. So let's just save this for now. If I want to display all the stockpiles in the same way, I can make use of the transfer label formatting. I hold my control on the keyboard down and click on all of the other stockpiles. So we have all of our product stockpiles now in the same appearance. As for the screen, we open the label options again, and here I would like to see the type of the screen and maybe the manufacturer. So type and manufacturer is part of the detailed label set. We're going to open this and look it up in the list. Right now I can't find it right away, so we can sort the list. The name is still selected, so now here we have the type, which is Nigra F-Class Scalper, and this is what I am going to use as the display for the screen. So because we have all of the screen associated with a certain type, I would like to use the same labeling. So to do this, I'm not just transferring label formatting, I'm also transferring label formatting and data. That means label will be formatted the same way, but it will also receive the same instructions as to what to display. So I click on this function, hold my control key pressed on the keyboard, and click on the screen labels. So the crushers are not associated with a certain type. I'm just leaving those showing their name, Cone Crusher and Cone Crusher 2. However, I would like to see them in the same format. Now let's modify the display of our cut labels somewhat. I open the label options for the cut label, and here I would like to show as little as possible so that the display does not get too confusing. So I don't want to show the rectangular frame around it, just want to show the number. Let's save this and apply this to all the other screen cuts. So now finally I would like to put some numbering on. Oh, I forgot the jaw crusher. So I of course want the show crusher show being shown in the same format. And let's put some numbering on. I add another label to our ROM stockpile, and this label I would like to set up as project number. And in order to stand out from the other information, I want to put an elliptical frame around it and fill it in yellow. So now each of the objects should receive the same number or the same numbering system. So, and to transmit this information, we just again use our transferring function. I'm going to do this for all of the objects. So add label. Okay, now let's transfer this information to the stockpile. So this is how we add the project numberings to our objects. Of more interest for now, of course, is the material information. So we add a label to the line, for instance, or we add another label to our product stockpile. So in this label I would like to have set up differently. So again, I open the label options, and here I would like to see the product tonnage in total, and I would like to see the spec min percentage and the spec max percentage. So you will notice that selecting spec min or spec max does not change anything on the appearance of this label. That is because we didn't set up the specifications yet. So a material label I would like to show in a different color, so I change the fill color to some pale green. Save. So now I put this label on the object. Delete the one that I don't need. So I add another label for this stockpile, for this, and for this. And for this. So, and I would like to that the all of the labels show the same information as this one. Hold the control key pressed on the keyboard and click on the individual labels. So let's save this for now and click on calculate once. So now we receive the material information. In order to work with specifications, I have to open the stockpile again here and enter a specification value. So this stockpile is receiving the undersize of a 40 millimeter cut, so therefore 40 millimeter is the interesting portion of this specification and we added to it. So now we can look at the label and it says a total of 8.2 tons an hour is the tonnage, and the percentage smaller 40 is 95.4. So we go to each of the stockpiles and make the same adjustments. This one here is receiving a minus 5, so the 5 millimeter is the top specification. Here we have 5, 10 and 20, so I'm going to adjust it in the stockpile accordingly. 5 millimeter for this material, a lower limit of 10 for this and 20 on the upside, no, a lower limit of 5 and 10 on the upside, and here the lower spec is, no, what is it again, it's getting the plus 10 minus 20, plus 10 minus 20. So this is about how we work with labels and the information therein. That also concludes this section of the tutorial.